Hello everyone, it's Vicky. I'm popping on really quick because I just did an Insta Stories live and I asked if any of you would be interested in seeing me paint this on here. And many of you expressed an interest in that, and so I thought, okay, I'll sit down and share with you kind of how I went from this to this, because I think that it was a really great transition and a really great experiment. And this is a Kate Spade Wellesley planner. I painted one of them, that like rose gold champagne color, to the Kate's, that really pretty Kelly green color. So I've painted planners before. I actually have videos up already on how I painted a Filofax Malden, and I painted a one of those faux Malibu from the Daytimer. So I've painted a few, and the reason why I paint planners is because I kind of want to give them another life. Like, I really liked the patent polka dot, and I just have not liked it more recently. And when I saw it sitting there on the shelf, I thought, I need to give it another life, or I need to give it another home. And so I thought I'd really like to see it as a cheetah print, or like a leopard print. I really like leopard print a lot. It's a print that I'm really happy with a lot of the time. And so here I am painting. It's quiet in the house. Dogs are sleeping. One kid's sleeping. The other one's watching TV. So I thought I will kind of pop on here and share with you how I did this. Okay, so I normally would use a special special paint on leather, because leather needs like a different kind of a paint. With the patent leather though, I thought I was just gonna go with acrylic, a heavy body acrylic for the black, and then just regular kind of craft paint for the rest of it. And the reason for that is because the patent is kind of a slipperier surface, and I thought I'd be able to handle it a little bit more. And with that said, in order to seal this, to make sure that the acrylic paint does not flake off, I will be using the Angelus, which I'll have linked down below. It's a satin kind of a varnish that will go over it in order for it to be sealed so that it does not chip away. I don't know how well that will work. I will of course keep you up to date. This is the first time that I've done acrylic paint on a planner like this with the patent leather. I'll let you know how it holds up, and we shall see. So I see a little spot here. I pull paint just directly from the tube, and the effect that I want to achieve when I'm doing a leopard print is, a lot of times there is the kind of brownish color in the center with like a half, like a C, a non-finished circle around it, and I try to kind of give it like a brushed look so that it almost looks like fur, and it doesn't look super perfect, like perfect C's. You can try playing with it like that, you know, experiment with it, use a separate piece of paper to do that with, you know, and just play around and see what you can kind of come up with. And so working here on the spine, I'm only going to show you here what it is that I did. First thing I did was paint over the dots with the kind of more taupe color. This is by Folk Art, and it's in like the color, I think it's called Bresca. It's basically like a brown, it's like an ochre. If you're familiar with ochre, it's kind of like a ochre color. And all I did was go over where the dots are and paint this ochre color. And the reason why I did that was it would just give me kind of an idea of where to put my like leopard spots. You don't have to do that. You can just paint it a solid color. But I kind of liked the idea of painting where the dots were, putting in those little cheetah prints. So this is actually a really like easy way for me to paint this planner, because I'm not like worried about painting the inside. With a lot of the other planners, what I had to do was, you know, coordinate the inside with the outside. With this one, I'm going to leave the zipper black because I think that matches really nicely. And the interior, I think it matches pretty nicely as well. I don't know, if I get really adventurous, I might change the interior to red. I mean, it's got the red in there, but if I want to change the leather, but I kind of really like what it is on the inside. So that's what I did first, was paint the dots. And then what I did was I took more of like this peachy kind of flesh tone color. This is by, Craft Paint, Anita's All Purpose Craft Paint. I don't even know where I got this from. And the name on here is Skin Tone. So kind of like a flesh tony color you want to get on there, that like peachy-ish pink kind of a color. And what I did was I went in between where I want to do the leopard spots, is what I kind of filled in with that. And it was okay that the two kind of blend together, because you want them to blend. It makes it look a little more real, as opposed to you just like covering up spots. And I have to work this in layers because the patent leather is got that like shiny kind of texture to it. So kind of have to work with adding to it. Otherwise, if you don't allow, and the great part about acrylic is that it dries so fast that you can work quickly and you can add more to it very quickly, which is really nice, especially when you're working on like a larger surface. Like if I did all the dots here on this side, then we could let this side dry and add more layers, which is really nice. So I'm just going to keep adding this on here. And what I might do is, I don't normally speed things up, but just for the sake of allowing the acrylic to kind of dry, I may speed it up and share with you just kind of how I fill in the rest of these and then allow these to dry. So let me do that. So unfortunately my video cut out as I was painting these little like leopard spots, but basically you saw some of it, and all I did was just continue to use like a flesh tone and then like a brown. I covered up just where the polka dots were and just filled in layers until I felt like it was covered to whatever I wanted to be covered. So it's just really up to you how thick you want it to be. I wouldn't recommend doing too thick because you don't want it to crack. So now to build up these little like C's, that's really basically all it is like little C's. And I have a wet brush, unfortunately, because it was in like a jar, but I like to just pull the paint out of the tube. It just makes it easier for me to do. And so I just basically paint C's, you know, start on kind of like one side here and paint a C. And it looks a little watery, and that's just because my brush is wet, so I'll just go over it again with black paint. But if you're using a dry brush, it'll be a little bit of a darker black on there. So it's just because my brush is a little wet. No big deal. I'll just go through it again. Okay, and then you could do like a little like thing in between just to kind of make that look, you know, like a more like a leopard. Yeah, and I'm just going to continue to do that all across the entire planner until I feel like the C's are where I want them to be. And you can change up the direction of the C. You can kind of change it up if you like. It just kind of makes it look more natural in the design, I guess. And then I use like a flat brush just to kind of make it look like it's got fur, just by dabbing it like this. You can do it however you want. If you want like more perfection, you can kind of switch your brush around. But You can see how it's already kind of coming to life. So I'm going to continue to make those little C's all the way across, and then once it's completely dry, and by completely dry, I'm probably going to give it an overnight dry just to make sure it's really, really dry. And then I'm going to take that satin leather kind of sealer coat that I want to put on there. I'm going to put that on there, and then we're going to see, I'll show you how that looks, and then we're going to see how it holds up. And then of course I'll have an update to let you know how this process holds up. Are they going to flake? Are they going to come off? I really don't know. I'll have to see as time goes on, because it's just not something I can predict. So let me continue with these little C's, and I'll be back and show you how that. All right, so I've allowed this to dry, and acrylic dries quickly, but I just wanted to be sure, so I let it dry overnight. I painted it kind of late in the day anyway. So now I'm going to be applying this Angelus brand leather acrylic, and this is a satin. I think this is worn off, but it is a satin finish on here, and that gives it a little bit of a shine without being like too shiny. Like, I used that on my green Kate Spade and really like how that turned out. So, and I'm just using a super cheap craft like sponge. If this doesn't work well, I'll just swap it out and get something better. And this process is pretty simple. All you do is just paint over it. I do two coats just to be certain, and I try to seal off like all the edges around. I try to make sure to get in there just because, you know, in case something starts like flaking or anything like that, that's where I assume it would happen. So I try to really do a good job of that. Okay, so I just opened it. It kind of was a little dry there. It's very watery. So just to kind of show you how watery this is, you can see it's almost like, I mean, literally like white water. Shoot. Yeah, it is just very, very watery. So you want to be deliberate with it and careful with it. And I don't know, it kind of looks like it's smearing my color a little. I don't really know. We'll see. This is all experimental, guys. So we'll see what happens here. But let me get some of that out there. I don't know if it's like a cheapy brush that's causing it to kind of smear a little bit. I don't know. We'll see. Or if it's just drying like that. Not sure. But it's all experimental. You know, or I may have to use the Angelus ink on here. We'll see. We'll kind of see. You can see how like the black is streaking a little bit. But it doesn't really bother me because it's kind of like turning it, if you can see, it's kind of giving it that sheen, that shine. So we'll see. So here it is. I put the top satin finish on there and did a little experimenting. On this side I use the brush, excuse me, on this side I use the sponge, on this side I use the brush. The brush works a lot better. I use just an old makeup brush, and the soft bristles, like when I painted across using large strokes, it didn't run the color quite as much as this rough, like cheapy sponge did. So definitely don't use one of those. Am I super distraught about it? No, because it's kind of like the color scheme is like that, and it's on the back. This one's the front. I'm glad I experimented it and got something for all of you to like learn from and get from. I still love it. Excuse me. I'm still going to use it. I really love how this turned out. I put two coats on there, actually. I put a nice heavy coats on there. You can see how it's starting to kind of adopt a sheen to it, so it's protected. Hopefully the acrylic that's on there, I'll let you know. I definitely love the experiment of this, but I definitely need this to dry at least 24 to 48 hours before I'm comfortable with zipping it, closing it, and tossing it in a bag. I've made that error before with my Malibu Daytimer. I got too excited with it and immediately like closed it up when I thought it was dry and put it in a bag and noticed that the paint would start to kind of get sticky. And because it was sticky, it was like paper was sticking to it. So you definitely want to give it enough time to dry. You can put it under lamps to dry, you know, pick up a little bit of that heat from there to kind of quicken the drying process. But I would definitely give it the 24 to 48 hours of dry time, because if you like close it too quickly, or like I said, you lay it on one side where you thought it was dry and it really wasn't, you're going to run into it being too sticky. So I'm going to give it the 24 to 48 hours, and then I'll come back and I will share with you how it turned out and kind of give you a little bit more up close picture. All right, and here she is, complete. The finish has dried now for about 48 hours, and I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. The back got a little bit muddy. If you remember, I used the brush, that real strong brush, so kind of drew in some of the colors, but the front looks really good, and it doesn't like catch my eye so much when it got muddy, because it kind of just looks like it's part of the print when it kind of dragged through. It's a lesson to be learned, and that's usually what happens with DIY projects. It's something to be learned from, but I really like it. What it's done, the satin finish on there, as you can see, it's added a sheen to it, so you can see that, but it also feels like when I first ran my hands over just the acrylic, it felt like it was a little bit more unstable and that it would chip off, it would come off, where it has this satin kind of finish over it. I feel as though it's a lot more protected and it's a lot smoother with that finish on there. So I don't feel quite as much of like that rougher texture that acrylic paint tends to have, which is great. I love it. And on the inside, I haven't set it up yet, but I do love the fact that I have the black and the red in here, because I feel like black and red and leopard are just some of my absolute favorite combinations. And I'm really thrilled about that. I think this turned out great. It turned into something that I think I'm going to use a little bit more than just that polka dot pattern. For some reason, I liked it initially, but this feels really, really good. Honestly, it does. And I've broken in the spine a bit, so it lays a little bit more flatter once it has more pages in there. So the setup for this, I usually only use like note paper like this. This is from that Target dollar spot, and it fits really well in here. And this is one of the Rapesco punches, and these work great. They come in like nicer colors now, but what's great about having just a bunch of these sheets in here, especially when I'm on the go and the type of planning that I do for work, what's great is I can do a lot of my note-taking on this paper, and it makes it just a lot easier. I hope I have that set up, yeah. So it just makes it a lot easier to have a bunch of this paper in here, as well as just monthlies is what I tend to keep in here. I don't really keep very many dailies, because when I'm on the go at work, all I really need to do is be jotting down notes, and then I need a calendar just for date references, just to kind of see what my availability is, as well as like checking time references. So like, you know, if I'm going to visit a kid's house and they had like a, you know, their port accessed on such and such a date, and they have orders for it to be accessed, you know, once a month or whatever it may be, I need to make sure with a calendar that is it. I don't necessarily like having my phone. I know a lot of people ask me that, like, why don't you just use your phone? It's gross. I just don't. Like, it's easier for me to have a planner opened up to a month, or to have it there and like wipe down. Oops. And to like, I don't know, you can wipe it on your phone too, but I just rather use this. It stays in my work bag. It doesn't come into my home. My phone, it kind of comes into my home. My kids use it. Like, so I try not to like bring it out at work. I don't like to rest it on anything. I just don't. So I don't mind so much, because I can just kind of wipe it down. And like I said, I leave it in my work bag. I don't necessarily bring it into the house. So that's how I plan on setting it up. Just kind of some note pages in here. In here, I usually have business cards that I may need to call. So a lot of kids that I go visit, they'll need like different, they have like numbers for different like medical equipment and all that kind of stuff. I tend to have those in here just as like a quick reference to call, as well as like the 24-hour number. And sometimes I have it programmed in my phone, sometimes I don't. But it's nice to just have like a reference here really quick. Same thing with different kiddos, different cases. I have like mom cell phone numbers. I usually have them programmed in, but sometimes I can't remember what the mom's name is. So if I have it written down in here, it's a little bit easier for me to use as a reference. So that's my plan, and I'm really excited with how this turned out. I couldn't be happier with it. You know, if you are looking to kind of change up a planner or have some fun with it, I highly recommend going and using some of that acrylic and playing around with it, but do make sure you put something on top. I do recommend that satin finish from that Angelus leather. It feels really right, is all I can say, is that it feels really good. It feels really right, and I love how it turned out. I'm really, really happy with this. Thank you all for watching. I hope you got inspired to pull out some of those planners off the shelves and give them some new life, and I'll see you all again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.